All right, today we're gonna focus on stretching. What we're gonna do is we're gonna do at the end of the stretch session a thing called PNF stretching. And what that is it's a technique kind of incorporating isometrics with stretching to just kind of enhance that stretch. So our focuses of today are to make sure we're continuously breathing, be aware of that breath, really focus on stretching. Get it to that point of almost uncomfort. Really gain that deep, deep stretch, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with our circles. We're gonna have hands over our head, pulling the isobel apart, probably about 20 to 30%, really just trying to warm our muscles up, get our blood flowing, and we're gonna do circles. Try to make as big a circles as you can. That's two, we're gonna go for five here. Three, keeping that tension on the isobel. Four, and five, we're gonna reverse direction. Again, really just focusing on warming up, getting our muscles and blood flowing. And one more. We're gonna come down, close to our body, out and up. That's one, two, three, four, five. At this point, we should start feeling it in our shoulders. Reverse direction, reverse direction. And we're gonna do two more. Excellent, keep that up, really just trying to get that blood flowing. Now coming in close to our chest, out to the side, to the other side, to the side, and the other side. Really starting to feel it in our shoulders now. Really feeling that blood flowing, tension coming, just kind of getting our mind and body ready, focusing on that breathing, okay? What we're gonna do is we're gonna come up, lean over to one side, really pulling down. We're gonna go to the right side here. Pull down with that right arm, really try to engage that left side, okay? We're gonna hold this for 15 seconds here. And really focus on that breathing. Other side, leaning to the left, pulling with the left, really trying to engage that right side, that lat, oblique, and rib cage there. 15 seconds starting, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, up. Here we're gonna do torso circles. Try to imagine your isobel being a pencil. We're gonna try to make it big circles with them. And reverse direction. And now we're gonna come down to our side, switching the isobel to a horizontal position here. And we're just gonna rotate back and forth. Remember to focus on that breathing there. Great, great, great. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our isobel, right hand over our shoulder, left hand coming up, grabbing the opposite side, palm up, and we're gonna pull the isobel down, really trying to push that elbow towards the ceiling, really engaging our tricep and shoulder, okay? We're gonna hold this for 15 seconds starting now. Switch sides, we're gonna take the isobel left hand now, coming over our shoulder, over our head, right arm coming up, grabbing the isobel. Something to consider if you can't quite get there, I know my bicep tendon's a little tight, what we can do is we can change these handles to a vertical position, gives you a little more reach, allows you to grab that isobel, okay? So here we go, 15 seconds, ready, go. Take a break, good job, good job. On this one, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the isobel, put it right behind our back, just like so. We're gonna bend our knees just a little bit, start engaging our hamstring, bend at the waist, and we're gonna try to push our hands up towards our head. Really feel this in the shoulders. Okay, take a break. Shake it out. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna have a seat. If you'd like a pad, go ahead and grab a pad. If you're on an already carpeted ground or something, that's perfectly okay, your comfort. We're gonna pull our right foot in, creating this figure four here. We're gonna take the isobo and we're gonna put it over our left foot. Grabbing the other handle with both hands. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna have our knees slightly bent. We don't want it locked out here, okay? Try to get our forehead to our knee as close as you can. Pull towards that desired tension, that desired stretch. Again, a good stretch should be right on the verge of uncomfortable. We're gonna hold this for 15 seconds. Ready? All right, switching legs here. Left leg comes tucked in, creating this figure four. Right foot isobo, both hands on the isobo, knee slightly bent, pulling our forehead towards our knee, holding it for 15 seconds. And take a break. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna lie on our back, keeping our left leg tucked in, kind of towards our glute, our butt here. Isobo remaining over our right foot. Pulling our foot towards our head. Imagine our leg as a lever. We want that lever kind of changing towards our head. Here we're gonna start our PNF stretching. Okay, so what our PNF stretching is you can imagine this lever. Once we get it to the desired stretch, we're gonna push against the isobo, kind of creating an isometric hold, but at the same time a stretch. So here we go, we're gonna pull it to that desired level, then I'm gonna push my leg against the isobo, and we're gonna hold this for 7 seconds. Ready? Go. Excellent, take a break, shake it out a little bit. This time we're gonna try to get farther than we were, a little more deeper stretch. Once you get to that desired feel, again, we're gonna create that PNF stretch and we're gonna push against the isobo for another 7 seconds. Ready? Go. Excellent, all right. Here we're gonna keep our right hand on the isobo, our right foot, and we're gonna pull it over to the side. And we're gonna create this stretch here. Imagine your leg as a lever again, trying to pull your leg up towards your head here. Again, creating that PNF stretch, so once you feel that desired stretch, we're gonna push against the isobo for another 7 seconds. Ready, go. Relax, loosen up again. And this time, take it a little farther up. Feel that stretch. Once you feel that desired stretch, push against the isobo for another 7 seconds. Excellent, excellent. Right now, you can really feel this right leg loosening up. We're gonna grab our left hand on the isobo, right leg, left hand. Keeping our shoulders square, we're gonna pull our left leg across our body. Getting our hips stacked here, shoulders square on the ground. Again, imagine that your leg is a lever. We're gonna pull it up to that desired feel, and then we're gonna push against the isobo for another 7 seconds. Ready, go. And take a break, loosen it out. You should really be feeling this in your lower back, your hips, all the way to your hamstring. Take it a little farther this time, up to that desired feel, and push against the isobo 7 more seconds. Excellent, excellent. Remember to focus on that breathing. You can switch sides here. Left leg, right leg comes tucked in slightly. Left leg comes up. We're gonna pull that lever to our desired stretch and push against the isobo, creating that PNF stretch. Ready, go. Excellent, shake it out a little bit. Next time we're gonna pull it even farther, closer to our head. pushing against the isomo again for 7 seconds. Here we go. Great, great. Again, feeling that all the way through our left hamstring, calf, and lower back. Now we're gonna take this isomo, help our leg go to the side of our body. We get to that desired stretch, and then we're gonna push against the isomo, creating that PNF stretch. 7 seconds starting now. Great, great. Again, remember, what we're doing here is we're stretching out our hamstring, inner thigh, calf, glute, and lower back. Back to it. Again, get that desired feel and push against the isomo. Perfect, perfect. Coming up, right hand, left leg. We're gonna pull our leg across our body again, keeping our shoulders flat, hips stacked, pulling our lever up towards our head. Remember to breathe. Once you get that desired stretch, push against the isomo, keeping that 7 second hold. Relax, shake it out a little bit, and back to it. Get to that desired stretch, try to get a little higher than last time. Push against the isomo, creating that 7 second hold. Excellent, take a break. Now we're gonna come up to our lunge position. We're gonna take our isobo. I like to take the isobo, put one handle to a vertical position. That way our foot kinda is cradled by the strap rather than the handle. We're gonna take this strap and we're gonna put it around our right foot, okay? So we should be looking like this. We're gonna get into a lunge. That means leg and knee creates a 90 degree angle here. We're gonna stand straight, pull the isobo up, creating a quad stretch, push our hips forward. Really trying to engage that quad and hip here. Remember to keep breathing. Switch legs here. We're gonna take this isobo, we're gonna put it on our left leg, left foot. We're gonna come back into that lunge position, creating that 90 degree angle. Hips up, squared, shoulders squared. We're gonna come up, bring our quadriceps stretch in, and we're gonna push our hip forward. Remember to keep breathing. Excellent, and take a break. Finish off with a few cat camels. We're gonna do 5 of these. We're gonna come up, creating our spine here, head down, and then up like this. Spine curved, spine out, focusing on that breath. And that'll be our stretch for today. Hope you feel a lot of relief tension there. Hopefully starting to relieve that joint pain and get your blood flowing, get yourself ready for the day.